Our first guest tonight is a very funny actor you know from movies like This Is 40, Anchorman, and the Ant-Man franchise. He stars in the new movie Ghostbusters, Frozen Empire, which premieres exclusively in theaters and IMAX on March 22nd. Let's take a look.
Ooh, gross.
It's the Hell's Kitchen sewer dragon.
Hold on your ass!
Phoebe Spangler,
you stay inside this car.
I have a ghost to bust.
All right, that was cool.
Gary, come on.
No, I know, I'm sorry. It's just the way she said it. It sounded cool.
Please welcome back to the show our good friend, Paul Rudd! So happy you're here.
Oh, thanks. I'm happy to be here.
And you got to, in the clip, you're driving the Ecto-1.
I know.
That's a classic car.
I know.
Even Jay Leno doesn't have the Ecto-1.
Eat your heart out, Jay. Yeah, he's got every car in the world, but he doesn't have that.
No. Do you actually, I mean, did you actually practically drive it?
I did.
Wow.
Yeah, not on that street.
Yeah.
I wish, but I pulled it into the firehouse. I drove for about 10 feet. But technically, I drove it.
How much, is it one of those things where when you even drive it for 10 feet, like a crew guy talks to you for like a full hour about how to do it?
Yeah, yes. And I did it a few times. And I, like, every once in a while, movies and stuff, you have to drive. And then they'll say, like, if you want, you can get out of the car. We'll have somebody get in and they'll back it up for you. It's like, I can back up a car. I know how to do it. I do have a license. After a few times, I was kind of tooling around on it. It's pretty cool.
Now, I've obviously done a great less amount of acting than you, but a few times I've had to drive, and I will say I find driving when I'm acting impossible because the whole time I can't, I'm like, what, how do you do it? Like, I'm just like.
Yeah, it's, well, also what's really strange is that when you're driving and you have to stop at a certain point because the camera is usually set, and so you really have to hit a mark with your car. It's not like when you're standing and you look and on the ground there's some tape mark or something and you can see where you're supposed to land when you're driving. You don't really have that. So sometimes they'll put sandbags on the ground so the tires will hit it. And it's such pressure.
Yeah.
But this story goes nowhere.
I do. It's going somewhere for me because I just want to say, I find it very emasculating to be bad at driving in front of a lot of guys. I always feel like every guy in the crew is better at driving than me. So when I drive, I always feel like they're like, not how I would do it.
Yeah, there really is pressure. It is nerve-wracking.
By the way, my wife would happily put sandbags in our driveway. She would, to prove a point, she'd be like, and then when you hit those, you can stop.
Yeah. Do you have, sometimes I remember when I was a kid, hold on, another story that's gonna go nowhere.
Oh, good.
My dad had like kind of nailed 2x4s, not nailed, but into the ground in the into the garage so that when you pulled in, you knew exactly where the car would stop to clear.
I can do you one worse.
Okay.
My father-in-law did that, and when I asked my wife when, she said, when I met you. And I want to know, I was 35. He was like, these kids, they don't respect driveways. You also, we talked about the Ecto-1. These are the photon packs. Am I saying that right?
Proton.
Proton packs, right. Photon's pretty good, though.
Photon's pretty good, yeah.
Can you go back and ADR it, or is it too late?
There's very little difference between an H and an R.
Yeah, almost done. These are practically very heavy.
Yeah.
Not fun to wear.
No, not really. I mean, fun because it's like, cool, I'm wearing a photon pack. But after a while, you're like, God. And then so, people would, thankfully, the guys in the crew would come out and put these kind of stands up that had wood on it, much like the 2x4 my dad nailed into the ground in the garage, that we could stand and rest them. So like, it looks ridiculous, sometimes all of us standing around. resting our packs as we're kind of like leaning on this thing.
But people are walking by being like, they're not real Ghostbusters.
Yeah. But they are heavy, and you know, they're impressive to really look at. You know, they do look like they should do something.
Yeah.
They really do. Things spin and light up, and there are wires, and it's heavy, and so it's like, clearly this isn't just a prop. This has to work in some way. This has to catch something.
Yeah. It doesn't have to be a ghost, but it should catch
just something.
Like
a
mole.
Yeah, more like kill some bugs or something in the corner.
You, we've talked about this with the last one of these, but amazing that you get to work with comedy legends.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you're with somebody like Dan Aykroyd, and obviously there's a million things to ask, do you feel like you're good when you're with comedy heroes of knowing how to ask? And
boy, it takes a while, I think, because I really am such a huge fan. I still can't believe, because they're all in this, and Bill Murray's there, and Dan Aykroyd's there, and I was working with Steve Martin and Martin Short.
Right, Only Murders.
Yes,
yeah.
And so it's like this last year or two, I've worked with, I mean, the Mount Rushmore.
Yeah, it really is.
And it does take a while, I think, to just kind of eventually work up enough nerve to say, hey, remember when you were in Blues Brothers? I mean, it was like... I feel like the Chris Farley sketch.
Yeah.
Oh, that was awesome.
Right.
But I do. And I have now gotten to a point, well, certainly, well, it's funny, like with Dan, I did ask him about Blues Brothers, and Belushi. And like,
yeah.
What was it like when you guys were starting? And I heard you guys bought a bar. And that's where you would have the after parties. How did that happen? And what was that like? And it's honestly, like, it is such a fun job, first of all, just to be able to do this. But to then drive the Ecto-1 or talk to Dan Aykroyd and say, what was it like when you and Belushi bought that bar?
Yeah.
Or, like, talk to Bill Murray or Steve Martin or Martin Short. It really is, for somebody like me, who's just such a huge fan. It's the greatest thing in the world. I hope I never get used to it.
It is. I've been lucky enough to have a few of those moments as well. And the other thing is there's no organic way to ask. You can't like fake and be like, oh, that just reminds me. What was Blues Brothers like?
Yeah, that's true. You really got to wait and then you jump in.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you're so good at this, Seth, and you interview so many people. I mean, have you, over the years, do you feel like you can now be in situations and it's easier for you to engage in any conversation with a legend?
Yes, because I think ultimately you just have to authentically say, I always wanted to ask you this. You know, and as opposed to like trying to find some backdoor in of like, that reminds me, you know, just be like, I'm just gonna ask you because I wanna know and I don't know how much longer this party's gonna go.
Right.
And that's the most fun part. And I think most of them wanna tell the stories.
I think you're right. I think they do. Do you get nervous though? Are you ever nervous meeting anybody or knowing you're going to have a conversation?
The hardest one was when Letterman was here because, you know, the thing he wants the least is for you to be like, I'm a huge fan.
Yeah.
Like that he would run away.
Right.
And so it was just like, just be normal. Like having to tell yourself the whole time, just be normal.
Yeah. And he was very nice and I mean, a great guy, but those are the ones where it's just hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think I've been lucky enough. And at this point, via SNL, you as well. Like if you meet Steve and Marty enough, you kind of realize like, they mostly just want to do bits.
Yeah.
And they don't hold themselves on a pedestal. Like if they're on a pedestal, it's your mistake for putting them there. Cause they want to like just do jokes and.
Yeah.
Make fun of each other.
Oh, it's so fun to see them also interact with each other and just the put downs.
Yeah, it's relentless.
Relentless.
Marty Short is so mean to Steve. And I think it's Steve's favorite thing in the world.
On Only Murders in the Building, one time Steve made a comment about needing a stand-in, and Martin Short just said, well, sadly, Steve, Edgar Winter is no longer with us.
The best. You feel like he's always got one ready and he's just hoping someone will set it up.
And every time they say something, it's the funniest thing you could say.
Yeah. And that's the thing where you're just like, I think today I'm just gonna be audience. So I'm not gonna try to compete.
That's exactly right. Yeah. It's the difference between somebody who's like okay at sports and a professional athlete.
Yeah. Well, I'm very happy for you that you're getting to work with all of them, and thank you for coming here and sharing. You're gonna stick around. Paul Rudd, everybody. Ghostbusters, Frozen Empire, all these theaters, 9 on March 22nd. We'll be right back with Paul Appel.